This is utter madness. Here is the simple truth. Senate Democrats refuse to fund the government unless we agree to their demands on something entirely unrelated. They want a deal on immigration, and then they'll think about reopening the government. It is a shakedown strategy that Senate Democrats have been talked into by their base. Now, I could go on and on about how cynical I think this ploy is, and I certainly do. But let me read you something Senator Schumer himself said in 2013, the last time we found ourselves in this position with a government shutdown. And here is what, in 2013, during a government shutdown, Senator Schumer said, quote, "No matter how strongly one feels about an issue, you shouldn't hold millions of people hostage. That's what the other side is doing. That's what's wrong, and we cannot give in to that," close quote. Let me repeat that first line. Quote, "No matter how strongly one feels about an issue, you shouldn't hold millions of people hostage," close quote. He was right. You shouldn't. But that is exactly what he and his party are doing right now. Here's something else that Senator Schumer said in 2013. Quote, "I believe in immigration reform. What if I persuaded my caucus to say, I'm going to shut down the government. I'm going to not pay our bills unless I get my way. It's a politics of idiocy, of confrontation, of paralysis," close quote. Politics of idiocy. His words, not mine. Here's one more quote from Senator Schumer in 2013 during that government shutdown. Quote, "We believe strongly in immigration reform. We could say we're shutting down the government until you pass immigration reform. It would be governmental chaos," close quote. Sadly, he had that right as well. Mr. Speaker, as we speak, furlough notices are going out to federal workers across the country. Half of the Defense Department's civilian workforce has been furloughed. Training for reserves has got to stop. Guardsmen have to be sent home. A number of states are going to run out of money for children's health insurance. And all of this is completely unnecessary. But Senate Democrats believe none of it is too high a price to pay for appeasing their political base. There is no reason for this shutdown. We have been, and we continue to be, willing to work together in good faith on immigration. But that deadline is weeks away. There is no good reason for Senate Democrats to keep willfully forcing a shutdown on this country. Now, I want to take a moment, and I want to address the men and women who work here in the Capitol and who work around the country in this government, whether you're in the military or in the reserves, or you're in law enforcement, or medical researchers, or people working at our national parks, whichever you do, wherever you are, whatever it is that you're doing for the taxpayers. Thank you for your service. Thank you for your sacrifices that you and your families make. We could not be more grateful. You should not have to go through this uncertainty. You deserve so much better than this needless shutdown. And we hope that it will end very soon. My colleagues, Senate Democrats shut down this government, and now Senate Democrats need to open this government back up. Stop holding our troops and children's health insurance hostage. End this reckless shutdown that is inflicting needless uncertainty on our country. Let common sense and cooler heads prevail. Come to your senses, do the right thing, open this government back up. I yield.